Hey guys, welcome to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Jessica. Thank you so much for joining us today. And if you are returning, welcome back. In today's video, I have three new Dollar Tree DIYs for you. They are super fun and easy, and they kind of have that boho feel to them that I am absolutely loving right now. But before we get started, if you are new here, I would love to have you join us by subscribing down below. This first DIY is probably my favorite out of the whole video, so I wanted to get right into it. So the first thing you're gonna need is this plastic garden dish from Dollar Tree. This can usually be found in their floral department. And the second thing I'm going to be using are these tumbling tower blocks. So this is the new 72 pack. It's awesome, you get double the amount that you used to. If you cannot find this larger one at your Dollar Tree, they might have the smaller pack. So they come in the size of 36. We're only going to be needing 8 to 12 blocks today. So just one of those smaller packs would be perfect. So I'm just gonna start off by taking out the blocks that I'm going to need. And like I said, you will need either 8 or 12. It just depends how tall you want your base to be. So I'm just going to start off by removing those stickers, and luckily they were super easy to remove, so that was great. And then you just want to flip your bowl over. We're going to be working on the bottom portion, and you'll see I kind of pointed out that little circle on the bottom. That is going to be your best friend right now. It is your guide. So you want to make sure that that little circle is right in the center. And we are going to just be gluing 4 block pieces right around it, just like this. It's going to form a plus sign, but you just want to leave that little gap in the middle open so you can see that circle right in the center. And to do this, I'm going to be using my favorite hot glue. If you've been here before, you know I always talk about these hot glue sticks, but they are the best. I just love them. I'll leave them linked down below, and they're about the same price as regular hot glue sticks, so I just think that they have such a nice strong hold to them, so those are the ones that I always use. So I'm just finishing up my fourth one here, and now I will have my first kind of level for the bottom. So you can stop here if you want. I kind of suggest just building it up at least one more layer. It kind of just gives it a little bit more kind of stature when it is on a table. It kind of just, you know, like raises the bowl a little bit more and just kind of gives it a nicer look. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just glue my second row right on top of my first one. I kept going back and forth whether I wanted to do 2 rows or 3 for the base. I did ultimately end up doing 3, but I kind of wish I had just left it just like this. With the 2 rows, it was kind of more simple and had a bit more of like a low profile, but I got a little carried away. Either way, honestly, I think it looks fine. It really doesn't change the overall look that much, but in retrospect, I wish I just left it 2 rows, but 3 is what I ended up with. So once you have all of your blocks glued down, you're going to want to paint your bowl. And to paint, I'm going to be using this Rustoleum chalked spray paint in the chiffon cream color. I love the warm undertones, and the chalked look kind of just gives it that matte appearance that I just love, and I think it really kind of makes it a lot more high-end looking. So here is my bowl after I did 2 coats on the front and back with that chiffon cream color. If I can find that spray paint, I will link it down below for you. And I think it looks great just like this, but I wanted to give it a little bit more visual interest. So to do that, I'm going to be adding some paint to it. First is this chalkboard paint that I picked up at the Dollar Tree. And then I'm also going to be using a little bit of a light tan color that's just a little darker than the bowl itself, plus some white and black acrylic paint. You just need a few dollops of those paints, and I'm working on a piece of parchment paper here just to make for really easy cleanup. And this is my painting toothbrush. That is why it looks so beat up. I've had this paintbrush for years, or toothbrush that I paint with for years. And the technique you want to go with is just dip it in a little bit of paint and then just run your thumb right across the bristles of the toothbrush. So you'll see by doing that, it kind of just gives a little bit of kind of texture to it. It gives it more of a stone look. It's just getting little speckles of paint all over, and you can kind of see it here in person. Trust me, it really pops and you can see it so much more. And by varying the colors, it just gives it a lot more depth. So on camera, you can't really see the white, but I promise in person, using just that little bit of white paint really helps it pop. And you just want to make sure that you get the front as well as the underside of the bowl. Here is how it looked when I was all done and it was finished drying. Now you could clear coat this if you like, but I think it's okay the way it is because I'm just going to be using it for decorative use. And this last step is optional, but I had so many of these cork bottom left over from a previous craft. So I'll pop a picture on the screen right here of what I had used them for. I made some wood coasters using these same tumbling tower blocks in a previous video. I will leave that link down below if you did not get a chance to see it yet. And I had a lot of these cork bottoms left over, and they are perfect when you want to display an item and you want to just be careful that it doesn't scratch your surface. So I just went ahead and put that on the bottom. You can find cork at Dollar Tree as well, but it's not always in stock. I will leave these cork bottoms linked down below just in case you're interested. And here is the bowl when it was all done. I think it turned out so beautifully. Those speckles of paint really elevate the look of it. And I just have mine styled here with some wood beads. And I do have a tutorial for that as well that I will leave linked down below. Moving on to our next DIY, you're gonna want to start off with one of these glasses from the Dollar Tree. This is actually a candle holder, so you can find that glass in their candle department. And then you're going to be needing some rope. So either the Dollar Tree rope, which I just showed, or you can pick up some rope on Amazon. So that is what I did here. Either one works for this. It does not matter which one you use. I just find that the one from Amazon can come in helpful when you just want one continuous strand and you don't want all those breaks in it. So I will leave that link for you below if you want to pick some up from Amazon. But like I said, feel free to use whatever you have, or this one from Dollar Tree is awesome. I love this rope. If you do pick up the Dollar Tree one, you are going to want to unravel it. So you'll see here, it unravels into three separate strands, which is awesome because you get three times the amount of rope for just a dollar. And that is the thickness we are going to want today. And I'm also going to be using a little bit of this white rope that I also picked up at Dollar Tree. And you just want to do the same thing with that. Just unravel it into three different pieces. And then of course I'm using my favorite glue, that Gorilla hot glue. Like always, anything I can link will be linked down in the description box. So I'm just gonna start off by putting some hot glue on the bottom of that glass. And I'm just going to be gluing the darker rope all the way around. And you're gonna want to glue it the full length of the glass for about four rows, I would say. Once I got to this point, I did not have to glue it around the glass the whole time. I was able to just wrap it a few more times. And then you'll see here, I'm just putting some glue because I wanted to put a strip of that lighter twine in between the two darker ones, just to kind of break up the color a little bit. So I just went in with one of my strands of the white for about, I think, seven rows or so, and then I just finished up my top with some more of that darker twine, and then I did do a finishing one around the rim of the glass. Just want to make sure that none of that glass is peeking out of the top. And now you can use this for whatever you like, but I actually went back to Dollar Tree. This is the next day because I didn't have anything to put in it, and I picked up some of these foam floral blocks. So they're very easy to cut. This one was a little bit too big, so I just went ahead and trimmed it there with a kitchen knife. Very easy. Once you make sure that it fits, you just want to put some hot glue on the bottom of it. That way it stays put. And then I picked up these flowers at Dollar Tree. I thought that this was a really great deal. All of these for just $1. And you can trim the bottom here, but I just like to bend it. I just find it a lot easier. And once you kind of have it bent, you can just push it right into that foam floral block. And that is it, you are done. If greenery is not your thing, you can of course just put some faux flowers in here. I think hydrangeas would be beautiful, but I love the greenery. I think it's just so neutral. It goes with everything and everyone's decor. So I figured it would look really cool in this phase. And now for our last DIY, we're gonna get started with this 8x10 photo frame from Dollar Tree. I love this one. That matte black really kind of gives it that high-end look. And then I also picked up these paint brushes from the Crafter Square. I was actually really surprised by the quality of these brushes. $7 for $1 is an awesome deal. And this is just some watercolor paper I already had on hand, plus my watercolor paints. If you don't have any on hand, Dollar Tree has a wonderful selection. You can also just use regular paper, but I figured I already had it, so why not use it? So I'm just gonna get started by taking some water and just covering my entire paper with a thin coat of water. And then I'm going to pick out my colors. So I started off with some mustard yellow, then I have some red, a more kind of cream colored yellow, green, and blue. And I just dipped my paintbrush in that water there, got some paint on it, and we're doing something super simple today. Trust me, anyone can do this. I wanted it to be really simple, but still kind of have that boho minimalist look. And we're just going to be making a sun today and a rainbow. So for the sun, all I did was just take that mustard color and make a half circle on one side of my paper. Once you get the majority of the paint there, you can just kind of water it down a little bit and drag that color towards the center. And then for the rainbow, very easy. You're just going to be making some arches. So don't worry about getting it perfect right away. Watercolors are notorious for just being so user-friendly and easy to work with. So just have fun with it. If this picture is not your vibe at all, if you just Google boho minimalist, you will have so much inspiration. There are so many beautiful and really simple art prints that you can use to inspire you. So you'll see here, my colors are very watered down, and I did end up using kind of a lot of brown in them. So for that red, to just deepen it, I did add a little bit of brown, and the same thing with the green and the blue. But that is it. It's pretty much that simple. Really fun to do. I forgot how fun watercolors were to work with. I definitely will be doing more of them this summer because they really are just so fun. So just to finish it off, I did go ahead and just deepen some of my lines there and then let it dry. Once it is all dry, we can just go ahead and frame it. So mine was a little bit too big and I just had to cut off that top portion there. So I used the paper insert from the frame to just be my guide. And here it is, beautifully framed. Now you can leave it just like this, but one of my favorite things to do is to actually frame it above the glass. So you'll see when I turn over here. So I left the matting there, but I do sometimes like to frame things above the glass so it doesn't have that glare. I just like to give you some options for framing your picture. And that is it for today's video. I really hope that you guys enjoyed these DIYs. I know I definitely enjoyed creating them. They were so much fun, really simple, and that watercolor painting was just so relaxing. I definitely have to keep that in mind as a fun activity to do when I want to just relax and take a break. But if you would like to subscribe to this channel, you can do so by clicking my picture right here, and you can check out this video for some more crafting fun.